Students, let us continue with the data transfer concept. So in the previous video I explained about the basic concept of the data transmission. So now let us see what is the asynchronous data transfer. So I said the asynchronous means at a regular interval. A data can be transferred at regular interval, that you call it as asynchronous. So let me write the points for this asynchronous data transmission, how the data is transmitted. In asynchronous data transmission, data transfer, the transmitter is nothing but the sender. The transmitter transmits data bytes at any instant of time. So this you have to be noted that in asynchronous, the data bytes at any instant of time. At any instant of time, and only one byte is sent at a time. So at a time we are sending only one byte. There is some ideal time between the two data bytes. So you can understand by this point that, so here we are not concentrating on the time, we want to just transmit the data at any instant of time, but the data has to be transmitted from transmitter to the receiver. So only one byte is sent at a time. So in between the byte you can take it can take some ideal time also, means it can hold the program for some time. By sending the bits it can be in hold. So there is an ideal time between two data types. Here the transmitter and receiver, operate at different clock frequencies. So here each system is independent to each other. The transmitter and the receiver can operate at different clock frequencies. There is no means condition that both the systems has to be operated in the same clock frequencies. So if you take the microprocessor and if you take the input output devices, if this one is a source and another is a destination, means the it can operate in different clock frequency and input output can operate in different clock frequencies. So here the data can be transmitted asynchronously from processor to IO and IO to processor. The data is transmitted asynchronously. Why? Because these clock frequencies will be different. Microprocessor clock frequency is different, input output clock frequency is different. So this is one of the example for transmitting the data in asynchronous. So here from input output to microprocessor, microprocessor to input output, the data is always transferred in the form of asynchronous data transfer. So to help the let me write that point, to help receiver start and stop bits are used along with the data in middle. So this is the main difference between the if you compare the differences between synchronous and asynchronous. In synchronous we are not using the start and stop bits, whereas in asynchronous we are using the start and stop bits. Why we are using start and stop bits? In synchronous data transmission, the sender is always sending the data to the receiver. He doesn't bother about whether the receiver is receiving or not. The data that is receiving is in the order or not, the receiver doesn't know in synchronous data transmission. But in asynchronous data transmission, it is main helpful to the receiver. Okay, so here the transmitter and here the receiver is there. So here the receiver can know whether the byte was completed or not. So to help the receiver, a start and stop bits are used along with the data. Suppose 8 bits of data is there. So this is an 8 bit data. So in between the 8 bit data is before and after, we are using the start and stop bits. So by seeing the start and stop bits, the receiver understood that I received one byte of data completely. So this is helpful to the receiver. So that service will be provided by the asynchronous data transmission. So to help the receiver, start and stop bits are used along with the data in middle. And in asynchronous data transmission, timing of signals is not important. That is, timing of signals is not important. Because here you are having the ideal time also. So, timing of the signals is not important in asynchronous data transmission. So, let me draw that synchronous and asynchronous, asynchronous data transmission. So, here the sender is there. And let's take, this is the receiver, sender, receiver. Now I want to transmit the data. 0110, and let's take, this is the, excuse me. In between that 8-bit data. Okay, so like this. So in between here the start bit is there and some bits. So here the sender and the receiver. So this you call it as a stop bit. 1 is stop bit, 0 is start bit. In between the each byte of data there is some ideal time, that you call it as a gaps between data units. So this is one data unit. So in between the data units there should be some ideal time, that you call the gaps between the data units. So for each byte of data unit is protected in between, a data byte is in middle, and in here the start and stop bit. So whenever the processor sees a zero is there starting, it is indicating, means the receiver, whenever the zero is occurred from starting bit, means the least significant bit, so the receiver understood, okay, the byte information is coming. So after the 8 bits is over, of the transmission of 8 bits, whenever the 1 is there, it indicates stop bit. Then the receiver understood one unit of data is completed. So again, if the 0 is coming for the next data unit, it indicates the start bit. After reading 8 bits of information, whenever it sees 1, it indicates another data unit is completed. So like that. So 0 indicates the start bit, 1 indicates the stop bit. So here the direction of flow. So this is about the asynchronous data transmission. Now coming to the different methods, the methods that are used in asynchronous data transmission. So let me give the brief idea. Methods used in asynchronous data transfer. So what are the methods that are used in asynchronous data transfer? So two types of techniques are used based on signals before data transmission. So those two types of signals are, one is strobe control and another is handshaking. So these are the two different methods that are used in data transmission. One is giving the strobe control, another is a handshaking. Again, in the strobe control is of source initiated strobe and destination initiated strobe. Initiated strobe. In the same way for handshaking also, you are having the source initiated using handshaking. source is destination initiated data transfer using handshaking. So these are the different methods that are used in data transmission, asynchronous data transmission. So in the next video, I'll explain about clearly what is a strobe initiated and what is a strobe control data transfer and the handshaking control handshaking data transfer. Thank you.